Hello, I'm Dr. Dennis McKenna. As always, I'm joined by Dr. Fred Venditti, our hospital system general director, giving you the update from Albany Medical Center on the coronavirus. Today is Friday, May 21st. Fred, this is our 50th episode.
50. Yes.
The other noteworthy 50 is Jason, who helps us out with this, is turning 50 this year. So that's our other 50 to report. So 50 episodes.
I wonder about our young fans in Connecticut, if they've done 50 of these.
They can send us an update.
Yeah, let us know.
Looking at the numbers in the 8 counties of the Capital Region, more good news. Yesterday, we had 108 cases in the hospital positive for COVID-19. Today, Fred, that number is 96.
So keeps going down.
Keeps going down. The number that is in an ICU also has gone down from 16 in the region to only 11 people in the region, 8 counties, in an ICU with COVID-19. That's 9 straight days where that number's come down.
Yes. Yeah. Tremendous.
Inside here in the medical center, also very good news. As you can see from our graph, we have 45 people in the hospital with COVID-19. We have 41 on the floor. We have 4 in the ICU, and Fred, we have 2 on ventilators. That is also a very low number. Let's put up another graph for 1 second. This is a graph that our analytics team put together. This is the number of people inside Albany Medical Center with COVID-19 who have been on ventilators. And as you can see, this also has an apex and came down. The high mark was back on April 9th, where we had 34 in the hospital on ventilators. So, Fred, we went from 34 on ventilators. Today, we have 2. Yeah, so it's great news. Great news. The number inside the 35 that we've been talking about all week is congregate living facility. And what's the update there, Fred?
The congregate living facility numbers today are 32. We've been hovering in that range pretty much all week, Dennis. But the 32, again, are people from nursing homes and group homes. We had 43 in-house today, so that means only 11 of our patients today came from the general community.
Okay. In that 32, I think we've started to do some testing on that population.
We have. So remember, those patients are here. They're still COVID positive through the nasal swab test. And waiting for that to turn negative so they can go back to their homes. So we decided to actually do some serology testing on them. So we tested 14 of those individuals, and 12 of the 14 actually have antibodies to COVID.
Interesting.
Yes. So more to come on that. I think we're going to do more testing, and we'll share more about that next week.
Very good. And I think you also have some other thoughts on lab testing as well.
So we're doing a lot of testing. So obviously the serology testing, as I just described, we have our serology research trial going on, and that testing is going forward with our staff. But we're also doing a lot of testing pre-procedure, which is required by the state to do elective procedures. And this is something we're tracking here at the medical center, but we're also sharing that information amongst the 12 hospitals that get on the phone every day. So an interesting number today, there have been 3,514 tests performed amongst those hospitals for pre-procedure testing. Only 14 have been positive.
So that sounds like less than 1%.
It's less than 0.4%,
right,
Dennis.
Right.
So extraordinarily low number of positives in that population.
Can you estimate approximately how much that costs the system to do that work?
So the test costs somewhere between $50 and $100. So those 3,514 tests may have cost the system as much as $350,000.
Okay. All right.
A lot of money.
That is a lot of money. And it's an important point, and we'll continue to talk about that next week as well.
Yes.
All right. Very good. All right. So we've talked about EMS here before. We've worn their shirts. It is Friday, but it's also National EMS Week. So once again, we'd like to thank all the members who are out there, who are first responders, who are both EMTs, paramedics, emergency medicine physicians who help with that population.
They've been on the front line of this epidemic, and you know, they've done extraordinary work caring for the community. Yeah. They deserve a lot of credit.
We want to recognize them. This is an important weekend. It's a national holiday. It's Memorial Day weekend.
Yes.
The history of Memorial Day goes back to the 1860s. Actually, if you read it, it's a little bit unclear exactly when they first started to celebrate it, but at least since the 1860s. And historically, Memorial Day honors those who have died in service of the country. So it's a really important holiday, not to be confused with Veterans Day, but often we think about service when we think about Memorial Day. And Fred, your father and your uncles were in the military.
My father was one of seven brothers. All seven served in some capacity during World War II.
Yeah, that's incredible. Yep. So as we go into Memorial Day weekend, it's very important for us to remember that. And we have a very special treat for you. We have a recent graduate from the medical school. In fact, she graduated yesterday.
Yeah.
I hope I get it right. It's Dr. Jessica Rivets. Rivets. And she graduated from medical school yesterday, and she privileged us with the singing of the national anthem. And so we're going to leave with that as we go into the weekend. We certainly hope you have a great weekend. The weather should be wonderful.
Should be.
We'll be caring here all weekend for our patients, and we thank our workforce who will be here this weekend caring for patients. And we'll leave you with Jessica, and we'll just ask that you please, once again, please take care of yourself, take care of each other, and we'll see you next week.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner